And welcome back to Let's Play The Last Express, Blind, the RPG chick. Do we go to bed?
Le train entre en gare de Bar-le-Duc. Bar-le-Duc, 3 minutes.
Go sleepy. Arriving at some station, but hopefully that doesn't mean anything. That's a spooky dream sound. We can no longer open the window. Look at that. Well, we know what that guy is doing. And the game should know what that we know what that guy is doing. I can't take that down anymore. Exit? Wait. Ooh. Ominous. What the hell? What do you... An egg in your mouth?
Why don't you make it sing?
Oh my. 3:38 in the morning. Well, we didn't get much sleep, did we? So that was all a dream this whole time. So in dreams, we can't open windows. Okay, I understand. Oh, what's up here? Nothing. I can't lean out the window. Oh, we're moving? Okay. Alright. Wait, wait. Up. Somebody open... That sounded like our door. That freaked me out. This is another way into that guy's... We're in too. What is this bomb? Oh no, we're back in ours. Wait. So confusing. In this one. No, it's locked. Okay, I thought we got in there too. What about the little hidden compartment? Wait. What? Down. In. It's not in there. Anything else to look at here? Where's the... Well, the bomb's in that room, obviously. You know, at some point we're gonna find something here. I have a feeling. We need to get in that room. Yeah, I can only look outside the window when the train's moving. That makes sense. Because it would just be too dangerous when the train is stationary. Now, he's not in there, so the bomb's either on him or in the room, obviously. And I can't get in the room. I wish I could just open that window. I gotta kill myself. I'm guessing if I do that too many times in a row, I die. Now for real, we're out here. Where is this guy? He's not in there. I have a feeling, let's go back to the chef area and the compartment. The luggage area. Mm. Who's playing the violin? Mademoiselle, what's her name? I guess they finally locked this guy's door. It's closed. They're snoring back there, too. There's like nothing going on here. Do I just go back to sleep? I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Gotta be hard sleeping, sitting down like all night. Oh, hi!
I saw your light. I thought you might be having trouble sleeping.
I had a bad nightmare. It woke me up.
Me too!
Can I come in?
Why not?
Hey. Oh, with the dog!
Untermaxel! Make yourself comfortable. I'm sorry the place is a mess.
Do you always carry a gun on your concert tours?
A woman traveling alone has to be careful.
I would have thought Max was enough protection.
You could shoot me now?
You are not Tyler Whitney. Who are you?
My name is Robert Kath.
What do you want?
Tyler Whitney was a friend of mine.
What's that supposed to mean?
What's going on over here?
Maxel, bleib hier. Sit.
What?
Let me through, I'm a doctor.
Слышите, как они поют? Таня, посмотри на его руки. Они покрыты шерстью. Черной шерстью. Неужели ты не видишь?
Vasili!
What are you doing? What kind of a doctor are you?
Тебя-то я знаю. Ты за мною пришел, убийца. Таня, подай мне нож. Я вырежу его сердце и скормлю волкам.
Дедушка! Oh, don't listen to him. He doesn't know what he's saying.
Vasili Alexandrovich!
Who are you?
Who are you?
Set it down over there.
Mais pour l'amour du ciel, que signifie ces cris? C'est impossible de dormir dans un tel.
Brew this in a tea and give him a cup every 4 hours. Can you do that?
Yes.
Very good.
Let's clear out. Let him sleep.
Got some herb, y'all.
Miss Tatiana, could I speak with you? I don't want to frighten you.
Can I eavesdrop on you?
Into my compartment while I was at dinner. No. Would you think I was very silly if I asked you to keep it for me? Just until we reach Vienna? Of course not. I would be glad to. You mustn't tell anyone. It will be our secret.
Well, there's still nothing to look at as far as I can tell here. I don't see anything. Hey!
Excuse me.
Pardon me.
Oh, I could talk to her for a sec. Wait.
Good night, Miss Wolff.
Good night, Mr. Whitney.
Nah. But she knows I'm not Mr. Whitney. She laughed.
Excuse me, monsieur. That is Miss Tatiana Obalanskaya's compartment.
I know that very well. I was trying to get in there. Thank you. This guy stops me from knocking on everything.
Excuse me, monsieur. That is Madame Boutarel's compartment.
Oh, sorry, I thought it was Mrs. Wolff's.
Monsieur, that is not your compartment.
Do I just go back to bed now?
Good night, Monsieur Whitney. Until tomorrow. That is not your compartment, Monsieur.
I want to talk to people. I'm trying to be sociable. I realize it's 3-something in the morning. But there's nothing to do in my bed. Let's try again, I guess. I don't know what that does. Zzz. It goes zzz. Zzz zzz zzz. You have another weird dream. Cool. Check out that castle. Can we get rid of that stain? What are we smelling? Where did we get this from? Can I cover? I don't think you do anything like this in the game. No. You can't, like, apply items to items. That's the sound of that. Okay. Last time I opened it, I thought it was the sound of somebody opening the door. Let's see how our friend's doing. Oh, what? Zaboom. What's going on with Zaboom? He's reading. I guess how to make a bomb. He already made the bomb. We gotta do something about that guy and his bomb. What the hell? But when?
Who is it?
Sorry.
Hi. How you doing? You come out of that one and go into this one?
Pardon me?
Don't do that, monsieur.
Hey.
Hi. M'shimnahanad. I can't say that. M'shimnahanad.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bonjour. S'il vous plaît.
Are you still here? Tell His Excellency I'd like to... Tell him I want to talk to him about the Firebird.
The American, Your Excellency.
Yeah, right.
I believe this time you want to speak to him.
Yes.
That guy talks. Or she talks. Hey. What up?
Yeah. Make yourself comfortable.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kahina. I think I will.
Good morning, Mr. Kahn. I hope you have good news for me today.
That depends. Do you still want the Firebird?
Do you have it?
What happened to Tyler?
The misadventures of
the
Mr.
Scroll?
Whitney and his colleagues are of no interest to me. Let us conclude this transaction quickly. We both have many other things to do. I with my collection and you with your travels and special interests. Your treatment of Vasili Alexandrovich, for example. Datura Stramonium. Very interesting.
I treated him good.
Simple.
Simple to us, perhaps. But few European doctors would have thought of it. Once in Nigeria. But I digress. Do you have the Firebird?
Not technically.
Then I shall waste no more of your time. I shall look forward to our next meeting, Mr. Cup.
The Firebird. So the scroll obviously has something to do with something real going on. We can look around in here now. He just let us stay in here. I'm not opening that yet. I want to see
nothing.
It is as I thought. The Austrian woman has the Firebird.
Forgive me, Your Excellency.
I told you so last
time. The Austrian woman?
Why have you not searched her compartment?
The compartment is guarded, Your Excellency, day and night.
That's right.
Ah, yes. The dog.
Oh, I am not afraid, Your Excellency. But if I enter the compartment, that dog will attack me. If Your Excellency wishes, of course.
I understand, Kahina. Several hours remain before Vienna. I will arrange a convenient absence for Miss Wolff. And this animal whose presence seems to make you so uneasy.
Oh my.
Then, Kahina, you will find the Firebird.
Yes, Your Excellency.
Why are they so certain she has the Firebird? Can I look at anything? Can I do anything? That's interesting. I've been there. What is this? That's like the one in my room. Oh, that goes out. I didn't realize that. What about this door? Oh, look at that. Oh. The sick man of Europe, the life of Abdul Hamid II, last Sultan of the Ottoman Empire, a memoir by his personal physician, Dr. Ismail Zadeh, something? Some months after his ascension to the throne, the Sultan traveled to Russia to greet and pay his respects to his royal counterpart, Tsar Alexander II. On this occasion, the Tsar presented the Sultan with a magnificent gift, a jeweled Chinese egg. The egg in our dream, right? A curious story attends this meeting, one which has since been embroidered by so many hands that even those who should know better now accept the popular version in preference to their own memory. I, as the Sultan's personal physician, can assure the reader that what follows is a true and accurate account. When the Sultan, in the presence of the Tsar and all his ministers, first opened the egg, he saw within the painted portrait of a beautiful woman. It struck him that the portrait bore a striking resemblance to his favorite mistress, a young girl from Konya, whose name was Jasmine. She was indeed a lovely creature with fair skin and long auburn tresses, and the likeness gave the Sultan an amusing idea. That night, after the day's festivities, as moonlight streamed through the royal apartments, the Sultan summoned Jasmine to his quarters. "My love," he said, intending to have a little joke with her, for contrary to popular belief, the Sultan had a fine sense of humor, "I have had your portrait painted," and he handed her the egg. What must she have thought, a young girl accustomed as yet but little to royal ways, as she took in her hands this magnificent treasure? The Sultan could scarcely have foreseen the girl's reaction, for no sooner did her gaze fall upon the portrait than, with a scream, she threw the precious egg across the room. As the Sultan rose in amazement, the girl shrank from him, pleading with him to spare her life. Enraged by her insolence, the Sultan drew his sword and slew the unfortunate child on the spot. Okay, there's a sense of humor, but no patience. Oh, is this a special, famous egg, like fabulous egg or something? Precious egg. By great fortune, the egg had landed among soft pillows and it was entirely undamaged. The Sultan picked it up, cradling it in his hands, and made sure that the Tsar's gift was intact. Still, shouldn't have killed her. Before closing the little cover to the locket, the Sultan decided to take one last look at the painted face that had reminded him of Jasmine. What he saw made him gasp in horror. It was indeed the face of Jasmine, but white and dead, with a gash in her throat. Of course, like most so-called tales of the fantastic, this one had a perfectly rational explanation, of which I was able to satisfy myself by an examination of the egg itself. The locket contained not one but two pictures on ivory disc that floated suspended in a thin layer of clear fluid. The extreme sensitivity of this fluid to light, and in particular to direct sunlight, held the secret of the egg. For some reason, whether on commission from the Tsar or simply as a macabre private joke, the artist who created the egg had made two portraits of the lovely woman who was his subject. Those who opened the locket in sunlight, as had the Sultan at court, saw the first portrait. Those who opened it at night saw the second. I tried to explain to the Sultan what had actually happened, but he was obsessed with the idea that the egg possessed supernatural powers. To him, Jasmine's fate appeared not an unfortunate accident, but a prophecy fulfilled. Believing the Tsar's gift to be an evil omen that would bring only death to those around him and sorrow to his reign, he ordered the egg banished from his sight. This token of the Tsar's esteem has now been lost to us, and like the splendor of the once great Ottoman Empire itself, has passed into the night of history, for I never saw the egg again. As for the Sultan's superstitious premonitions of disaster, events which I saw subsequently relate will show that, like the girls, they were all too amply fulfilled. Alright, let's... Is this the way out, or... No. The doors look exactly the same.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bonjour.
Monsieur, please. There will be trouble. I cannot be responsible.
Pardon me?
He doesn't like when we knock on anyone's door.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Mechner.
But we can knock on these.
Monsieur, excuse me. That is not your compartment. Excuse me, Monsieur Whitney. This is not your compartment.
That's my compartment, but there's nobody in here, right? Not this time. Nobody with a knife.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bonjour. At some point, we're gonna do something with this, right? Who's playing the fiddle like a madman?
Milos, we need to talk.
Pazi, where's the Naurogen?
August Schmidt thinks I'm Tyler. I went along with it to keep the game going. Now I want to know what the game is.
And when you should говориш.
Oni je brežano Tyler's prijatelj.
Tebi je svako prijatelj.
Kamaj, sit down.
Have you heard of unity or death?
Sure. That's Harvard's motto.
Unity or death?
Unity or death is a sacred vow. Crna ruka, we have all taken it. Tyler too.
He always liked that sort of thing.
He gave his life for this. Tyler came to us in the winter. We were hiding in the mountains of Bjelašnica, north of Sarajevo.
Šta se njega tiče gde je Bjelašnica?
Oh, that's like a...
Oh, da pustiš da govorim.
Submachine gun?
When Tyler came, we had no food, no guns, nothing. Tyler brought us guns.
What did Tyler want from August Schmidt?
Tyler was given a mission by the general himself. It was a great treasure that belonged to the Serbian people.
What was it?
It was called the Firebird. I never saw it. Tyler was to sell it for gold to buy the guns from the German. If the German finds out that we have lost the gold, everything is lost. You must tell him that we have the gold and that we want to buy the guns.
Why should I help you cheat August Schmidt?
Cheat him? How can you speak of cheating a German? The Germans are taking our land, the food from our children. We are like slaves in our own land. Tyler understood this. If you betray us, you betray the cause he died for.
It's your cause, not mine.
I didn't see what she had at first. Are they Russian? I guess we don't speak enough Russian to understand.
Herr Schmidt mentioned that he was having some merchandise put on the train at Munich. So long. Madame?
See, at first I thought she was holding an umbrella or something. That is not an umbrella.
Pardon me.
The Serbian gentlemen are not in, monsieur.
Mr. Delnico.
Excusez-moi.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Excusez-moi, monsieur. Ah, je t'ai eu.
What you got?
Hey, reviens. Je ne te ferai pas de mal.
Je got over there.
Où es-tu? Je m'excuse.
Hi.
Pardon me? Pardon me?
Talk to her.
Would you open my compartment, please?
But of course, mademoiselle.
Excusez-moi. J'ai vu un scarabée noir.
Vraiment?
Black
oui.
Beetle.
Et je l'ai attrapé. Mais il est parti.
Bonjour, monsieur. Est-ce que vous avez trouvé un passeport?
Herr Whitney, soon we will arrive in München. Are you ready to proceed with our agreement?
What's this?
The answer is yes, Herr Schmidt. Our deal is on.
What does he have? I don't know what he took out of his pocket.
The Orient Express is now leaving for Vienna, Budapest.
Bitte sehr vorsichtig sein mit diesem großen Koffer.
Ja,
ihr sagt um Gottes Willen nicht hinfallen.
Meine Damen und Herren, der Orient Express fährt jetzt in Richtung
die Is that the Firebird?
Belgrad und Konstantinopel ab. Bitte alle einsteigen.
Я вижу, вы такая же бесстрашная. Девушка, играете в шахматы как мужчина.
Ваш ход.
So we have a deal with that guy too?
Замечательно. Трюк, достойный вашего деда.
Но почему вы все время вспоминаете деда?
The Beetle.
Ведь вы же со мной играете, а не с ним.
Он вас хорошо играть научил.
I've had other teachers since then, Алексей Сергеевич. I'm not a little girl anymore.
No, you're not.
Can we get it? I don't know if it's possible to actually get it. I'm pretty sure I clicked on it a couple times.
Sort of herbal tea.
Oh, well, I'm sure he knows what he's doing. Still, it does seem a little irregular. Yeah, not that we English see anything wrong with a cup of tea. It can do wonders for an upset stomach. Still, one rather expects to see the usual paraphernalia. A doctor's bag instills confidence and so on.
Herr Schmidt, given the are you having lunch alone?
As a matter of fact, I suppose Mr. I'm waiting for a lady.
Quite a bit of luggage.
Have a nice wait.
No, you know, so many Americans do.
I cannot say, monsieur.
The fellow I passed just now in the smoking.
Luckier than I am.
Rather young, isn't he, for a doctor?
I believe he's young, yes.
Talking about me.
He didn't look at all like the usual sort of American one expects to see on these trains. You know, flashing money about. Quite the opposite, in fact. Rather unusual for a young fellow like that to book a double compartment, prices being what they are and all that. Wouldn't you say?
I do not know, monsieur.
Well, I suppose he wants his privacy. Nothing wrong with that.
Monsieur, I really must return.
No, of course, of course. Don't let me keep you.
Thank you, monsieur. Au revoir.
Who's asking about us?
Ah, Miss Wolff. Please, let me help you.
Oh, thank you.
Are you comfortable?
Yes, I'm so glad. Everybody wanted to sit in your seat. I've been like a soldier fighting them away.
Oh, really?
I would not let anybody
Premier
sit service. Here.
Premier service.
She really likes him, Shemina.
What shall
lunch
we order? Is served.
Shall we get some wine?
That would be lovely.
I think good red wine, yes? Oh, forgive me. Perhaps Premier you would service. Like something lighter?
My father drank red wine and I'm afraid I picked up the habit. I know it's not very ladylike.
Nonsense. We will be able to share a bottle. I hope I will not get drunk.
Facey.
Oh, I'm turning into a happy little devil, especially when I am surrounded by a beautiful lady.
What a charmer.
You are a charmer.
There you go. Classic.
Bonjour, monsieur, madame. Avez-vous fait votre choix?
Madame and I will have both the roast chicken, and we begin with fish soup.
Oh, thank you.
And a bottle of your best Chateau Lafitte 1904.
Very good, monsieur.
On the train, the wine is ruined anyway by the vibration.
Hey, I don't get served? What the hell? Alright. Oh, Ms. Wolff is out of her... Okay.
Then that must be your family I saw next door.
It is most probable.
Excusez-moi, monsieur.
By the way, I was wondering, you haven't seen a red cravat anywhere, have you? I was just unpacking and it seems to have disappeared.
I believe my son has taken it.
Really? What was the name of the town you mentioned? Of course, the new oil refinery they're building up and down. I say, you're not working for Anglo-Persian, are you?
Why not?
Well, I suppose you being a Frenchman, I just assume...
I am an engineer, monsieur. The Anglo-Persian company is doing the most innovative research in oil exploration.
Yes. Well, wouldn't want the Royal Navy to be caught short of fuel oil, would we? Tell me, are the reserves in that little town, what's it called again, really as big as they say?
I cannot offer an opinion, monsieur.
No, of course you wouldn't. Quite brave of your wife to go all that way and live in the desert.
She would not wish to be without me. And it will be a good opportunity for Francois. He has a fine scientific mind.
He seems like a very active little boy. I don't suppose you could ask him for my cravat.
I think now that I remember him using it as a kind of sieve to test salinity in the water. Most remarkable in a boy of 7. Don't you agree?
Quite remarkable.
That's the kid next door?
It is the curiosity of the scientific mind, monsieur.
Yes, and all that trapped in the body of a little boy.
Huh. Is this kid 7? Does he have a scientific mind?
Oh, good lord. Silly business with Madame K.O. again. So typical.
Le train entre en gare de Salzbourg.
Ni l'un ni l'autre ne semble apprécier le
voyage. Salzbourg, 10 minutes d'arrêt.
D'habitude, l'allemand dépense l'argent généreusement.
Déjà. Why do the tawdry details of a murder trial exert such a fascination for the public mind?
Je crois qu'il convoite la petite chanteuse angélique du numéro 11 qui nous a donné une sérénade toute la matinée.
But still, the
quand
French
un homme du monde veut attirer l'attention d'une jolie
six
femme,
tu
peux compter sur lui pour qu'il dépense beaucoup d'argent.
Si tu as bien vu, peut-être que j'en serais bénéficiaire. De toute façon, je garde espoir que le garde du corps du RM sera plus généreux.
Excuse me.
Tu sais à
quel moment j'ai pris ma famille à lunch.
C'est
pas vrai. Avec quelqu'un comme ça, on ne sait jamais.
Peut-être que je vous verrai dans le restaurant, car
d'ailleurs. Vous menace, et puis un petit cadeau à la fin du voyage, et on peut prendre sa retraite sur la Côte d'Azur.
La Côte d'Azur, c'est pas pour moi.
So I was listening to them and reading them.
1914 sera ma dernière année en Europe. Si tu pouvais voir la jolie petite maison qui m'attend à Alger, l'Europe ne te manquerait pas non plus. C'est un paradis pour ceux qui savent l'apprécier.
Demande donc aux dames des derniers compartiments.
Attention, tu ne veux pas risquer la récompense que tu espères recevoir à la fin du voyage, non ?
Récompense ? La seule récompense qu'il risque de me donner, c'est de faire de moi son collègue avec son sabre. Allez, à bientôt.
Allez, à plus tard.
Yes? Who is it?
Sorry, Milos, wrong door.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Who's down here? This is ours.
Excuse me, Monsieur Whitney. This is not your compartment.
There's a bomb in there, man. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And endure. An enduring restaurant.